Yeah, let's talk all about it. I have been planning this day for years. I remember sending Damon a text message saying, Damon, I will not be at work April 8th, 2024, but I may not be at the station, but I'm working for sure. It's going to be an absolutely amazing event. It's been about 106 years since Oklahoma has had a total solar eclipse. I mean, totality. Let's talk about the maps. We'll have the director pull it up here. And so when it comes to totality, it is night and day difference. The gray is partial. The black part is totality. That yellow line is the line of totality. And there will actually be a difference between 100% and 99%. So if you're in OKC, you will not see what I will see down in Idabel. Let's talk about the timeline. Now, for Idabel specific, that's the map that you're looking at here. The partial eclipse, or when the disk of the new moon will start covering up the sun, that happens at 12:30. The total eclipse is going to happen at 1:45 down in Idabel. And what will happen is the skies will come dark, almost like the sun has set. You'll see like a white ring around the moon. Now, here in Idabel, in totality, you can actually take your eclipse glasses off. You cannot do that with the partial eclipse. You cannot do that in OKC. The shadow of the moon is moving about Mach 2, about 1,200 miles an hour. This is going to be a lot different than the last total eclipse we had in 2017, because that only lasted about 2 minutes. We get double the time, 4 minutes of totality. So it's going to be absolutely amazing. The peak is at 1:47 down in Idabel, and the partial eclipse will end at 3:07. The times are similar in OKC. The partial starts at about 12:30. It'll peak at about 1:45 and end at 3:04.